KB is provided by Bay State Dental. Comprehensive dentistry at 14 convenient locations in Springfield, Chicopee, Longmeadow, West Springfield, Belchertown, East Longmeadow, Ludlow, Northampton, Greenfield, and Wilbraham, as well as 29 Broad Street in Westfield. Bay State Dental makes it a priority to help you achieve and maintain the healthy smile you deserve. On the web at baystatedental.com.
We thank the generosity of our underwriters. For more information, please contact the Westfield State Foundation at 413-572-8646.
It's Tuesday morning from 6 till 8. Wow, it's Tuesday with Bob Plass.
Community Radio,
89.5 WSKB.
Live from the campus of Westfield State University, this is 89.5 FM, WSKB, Westfield.
again. Good morning and welcome to Superintendent Spotlight with Zap and Chris on a beautiful Thursday morning, Pete, 62 degrees.
Isn't it nice having windows?
Sun.
Having windows out here you guys can look out at?
Absolutely. Absolutely. Broadcasting live from the Graphic Arts Department at Westfield Technical Academy in what is going to be our, you know, our studio. Moving forward, not just for our shows, but for
Westfield Community Access.
Westfield Community Access. And ultimately for the program that we've talked about in terms of part of the Graphic Arts Department, you know.
Or maybe they're talking about it being its own shop.
Or its own shop, right, for TV, radio,
correct,
you know, for kids.
Yep.
So this is great. I mean, it's coming along.
It's a start.
Yeah. It's a start. Yeah.
I have a data connection so we can get a show out of here.
That's right. That's right. Absolutely. And with me this morning, not the superintendent, not Zap. He's got his hands full with something very positive right now. But
I think the Secretary of Education is coming.
That's correct.
Yes,
that's
why there was no In the Flow with Rob and Joe today. So
that's right. So Commissioner Riley's coming. So the boss is going to be with him today, and rightfully so. So in his place, my co-host, the esteemed Director of Assessment and Accountability of Westfield Public Schools, Mrs. Denise Rosala. Good morning, Denise.
Good morning, Mr. Rogers. How are you today?
I'm doing just great. You know, it's funny, Pete, because we Stefan and I were talking about this the other day, looking so far through the year, I think, since we've started, Stefan and I have done one show together.
Correct, yes.
Correct. We've done one.
I think we need a new title for when Chris and I are on. I mean, we tend to co-host quite a bit.
Right. So, well, we did have a name for the show.
Piece.
Say Your Piece with Chris
and
Denise.
Yep.
Perfect.
Awesome.
Joe's
fact,
good at those taglines.
He really is. And in fact, next week's show is Fort Meadow is going to be our guest, and I'll be hosting, and I will need a co-host again because Stefan's not available that next week, and then
Fort Meadow is one of my favorite places, so maybe I'll just sign
great
up right now for
that
it.
That sounds fantastic. And then the following week on the 18th is Westfield High School. We'll be our guests on the show.
Okay.
And Stefan and I, Zap and I will be back together on the mics on that particular day.
Okay. Those are shows we could also take on the road too.
Oh, absolutely.
Because we do have that corner of the gym that we can broadcast out of too.
Yeah, that's true. That's true. And then October 25th, Abner Gibbs Elementary School will be our guests. And our
nice.
And Mrs. Rosala, who's our guest today?
Well, today we have Rachel Bullock from the CPAC. She is here to tell us what CPAC is and what they do, and you know what types of activities and things they're going to be bringing to our district. So, welcome, Rachel.
Morning, Rachel.
Morning. Thank you very much for having us. And we also have another parent who will be here shortly.
Will be joining us shortly.
Michelle Douglas, who is on her way. So.
So it's awesome to have a couple of board members from our CPAC, and mm-hmm. and as Pete always reminds us, whenever we're throwing acronyms around, the very first thing we have to do is define those acronyms. So Mrs.
Means.
Bullock, I'm going to leave that
so
right
CPAC
to you.
So CPAC is the Special Education Parent Advisory Council, and we're a group of parents whose children are on IEPs, or they can also be on 504s. Currently, we have actually five of us that are heavily involved. Melissa Rakowski, Michelle Douglas, Laura Marks, and Don Altieri. So between the five of us, we all do different things. Michelle, who's on our way, she does all of our emailings and stuff. And then we all each pick a month to help plan different meetings that we have. So tonight we actually have a meeting. The Federation for Children with Special Needs is coming, and they're providing a presenter that will talk about basic laws of special education and what those acronyms mean as well.
Yeah. And there are a lot of acronyms in special education. If you think general ed is bad, special education has many, many acronyms.
And I believe that's taking place here tonight.
Here tonight,
correct?
At 6:30, yes.
In the cafeteria?
In the cafeteria, yeah.
Excellent.
And we have
if I recall, I think refreshments are provided.
We do provide refreshments.
A great group of people. Been to several meetings.
And we have the Westfield High School NHS that provides child care for us.
We encourage parents to come on down and find out what CPAC's all about. If you haven't been to a meeting, this is a really good one. Beautiful night to come out.
Mm-hmm.
I believe there's an article in the paper about it too, right?
Yep. I happen to bring it. Yeah, Miss Amy Porter.
Yeah,
she's wonderful. Again,
Amy
Michelle
is great.
Gives Amy a heads up, and then Amy's wonderful enough to put it in the paper for us.
Well,
we have a Facebook page as well.
Yes.
And Facebook,
an email, I think,
and
as
we
well.
Do. Yeah.
Westfield, what is the email address?
It's westfieldcpac@gmail.com. Our Facebook page is Westfield Mass Special Education Parent Advisory Council. Because, as you've said here on the radio show before, Westfield is also in New Jersey, so we had to put Mass.
I have done that Google search a couple
actually,
times.
Actually, it's kind of funny that you bring that
in
up.
In Indiana.
Yeah, Indiana, there's a few
too.
Westfields. Yesterday, I was emailing a counterpart of mine in a school system in Connecticut, and I said, you know, my name is such and such, and I put Westfield, and then I put, wait a minute. And then in parentheses, I put Mass. So it's just like you said, there are a few Westfields out there.
Well, even on our Facebook page, we've had people chime in saying, is this in New Jersey? And we're like, no, we're not New Jersey. So.
Well, so you talked about tonight's event, but there is a pretty much a CPAC calendar. The organization is hosting events pretty much through June, about once a month, I believe, right?
Yep, we take January off. To give us all a
to
break
regroup.
And get over the holidays and stuff like that. So, tonight we're having the basic rights. In November, we have to actually meet on the second Thursday of the month because November 1st is actually the technical's open house.
Yeah, that's right. So, WTA's open house is November 1st.
So that particular meeting, we had to go to the second week. And that's going to be on transition planning by Mrs. Elander from the East Mountain Transition program. Oh, there's Miss Michelle.
Good morning, Michelle. Welcome.
Just pull up a chair.
Yeah.
Sorry.
That's okay. Good morning. And folks, we're going to introduce our other guest today, also a board member of our CPAC, Michelle Douglas. Good morning, Michelle.
Good morning. Good morning.
Thanks for being here today.
That is perfectly
fine. I had to drop off my little minion. So
that's okay. That comes first. Absolutely. So, again, Rachel, tell us where we're at in terms of the events that CPAC has planned for the year.
Well, tonight is our first workshop, our basic rights, which every year the district has to put on a basic rights workshop. So this year we have the Federation for Children with Special Needs coming down from Boston to do it.
That's excellent.
It's tonight in this building at the Tech in the cafeteria, and it starts at 6:30. And there will be childcare and refreshments. And we'd love to have people come down and see what we're all about, and we'd love to get more people involved.
Right. And then you talked about November's meeting being primarily the transition program with
transition
with
at 14.
At 14, right. Yeah. Right. And Sherry's a real good resource for that. No question about it.
Yeah, absolutely. And then in December, we decided that, and this Don Altieri's in charge of this one on our board, and it's called the IEP Checklist for Success. So we just felt like, special ed stuff is so overwhelming, and then when you go into an IEP meeting, they cover so much about the child and stuff. So we thought maybe if we just made a simple piece of paper that had highlights, and then you kind of could take it with you to at a meeting and go, okay, well, did we cover this? And then check the box.
Simplify the meeting for the parent, because like you said,
because you're bombarded with so much information you're like, well, where did we leave off? Where did we start?
I think a lot of parents don't even know that, like, you can come in with your parent concerns, or you can email them before, and that is supposed to drive
the whole process of the meeting
from your end.
Right.
And
So the goal is to have a more interactive session as opposed to having someone standing up there and talking to people for an hour.
So with Martha, our
Dr. Von Mary.
Dr. Von Mary. Yes, I'm sorry.
That's okay.
Special Ed Director.
Our
she said to call her Martha.
We call her Martha, but for listeners, they'll know Dr. Martha.
So she has, she had a template for this, and she said that what she had done in the past was made it like a Jeopardy game. So that's what we're thinking of trying to do it. So it will be more interactive and a little bit more fun, and maybe we'll have some prizes that people could win. You know, nothing major, but, you know.
That's exciting. That sounds like a great meeting.
No, so hopefully that'll be a little fun. January, we're taking off to regroup, and then
Oh, in February, we're doing the Let's Get Organized workshop, which we've done that before, and the Federation does that as well, where basically they just show you how to organize this big pile of mess that you usually have at your house. So I have my pile sitting there waiting for me.
For that meeting.
I know. No, well, I know how to, I've got it under control. I just have to get to the time to actually put it into the binder that is there in the Staples bag. So, it can be overwhelming. There's a lot of paperwork.
Right. Testing results.
Yeah.
Progress notes.
Evaluations. Right. Progress notes. Everything under the sun that you can have.
Yeah. And so then in March, March is my meeting, so we're in the process of trying to. This is a fantastic book. It's called Bright Kids Who Can't Keep Up, and it just talks about processing speed. That some kids are slower. It's not that they can't retain the information or know it. It's just that they take a longer time to do it. And these folks, this was a very easy read book, and I wanted to start a book club and get people to read this book. And then the authors are from Boston, and so I've sent out emails trying to see if we can get at least one of the authors.
Oh, that sounds super interesting.
That would be great.
Yeah,
so,
I want to read
who are
that.
The authors of that book?
So the book is by Ellen Bratton. She's the director of Learning and Emotional Assessment Program at the Mass General Hospital.
Wow.
And Brian Wallaby.
Yep.
He's a staff psychologist at the Learning Emotional Assessment Program at Mass General Hospital as well. And
The LEAP
faculty
program?
The LEAP, yeah.
The LEAP program, yeah.
Yeah. And a faculty member at Harvard. So
yeah,
I'm
the LEAP program, they're supposed to be like one of the top.
Oh, are they?
Oh, yeah.
Well, it's a great book, easy read.
Okay, Pete, so the windows are really great, but totally distracting us right now.
Don't mind the dumpster guy.
I was going to say, it's
the
no
loud
big deal
noise
that,
you hear, he's emptying the dumpsters.
This will be a learning experience for not only us, but the students in this studio that, you know, when we're in the middle of a program, we've got to be cautious about looking out the window.
Well, whether we were looking at it or not, we were
going to hear that. I heard that over the microphone, yeah. So I was like, wow, okay.
Well,
a book club sounds like an awesome way to get parents involved and engaged, especially
I want to read that.
An easy
so,
read.
Yeah,
it sounds book. Interesting. And so is that what you're going to focus your March 7th meeting on, possibly?
So, yes. I mean, you know, I'm going to hope and pray and beg to see if one of them can come.
Absolutely.
And certainly, even if maybe they could, you know, Skype in or do something, I think we can try and do something.
Oh, that's great.
Yes. And then
in April we're going to try to do a social skills 101 workshop. And it keeps popping up the person I need to contact to do that. So I don't want to put her on the spot over the radio because
sure.
I haven't contacted her.
She hasn't confirmed, right?
I haven't.
But she's done it before.
She's done it before, yeah. And she's like the top person in the high school who does a lot of work with kids with autism. So...
Who's Miss Karen Kennedy?
Karen Kennedy. She's awesome. So, and it keeps beeping on my phone. So, Karen, if you're listening, you're going to get an email from me.
You're signed up for April 4th.
But yeah, she's done it before, and she's great. And she just, I'm just praying that she's still there at when my son gets there. But she's great. She knows a lot about. Social skills and the social thinking curriculum, which is used a lot. So,
excellent.
And then in May,
that's a favorite event for everyone in May.
Yeah.
Yeah,
that's
so
yours.
You're
saying yours, mine.
So in May this year, we'll have our fourth Shining Stars Award, where parents, students, and guardians are able to write in about teachers or any staff members, actually, who went above and beyond for their child and, really helped them out. So
Last year, I think we had 27, and actually this year, we're moving up in the world, so
wow,
I made it.
You had a photo book done?
I did. Yeah. I had a photo book done. That's Mr. Rogers saw it the other day at the middle school open house, so...
And it's you just, saw it before me.
So do you send out nominations, or how would if a parent feels that they have someone?
Well, I'll tell you what.
We want to come back to that.
Yeah, we're going to come back to that because we're up against our first break right now. But I think that'd be an excellent segue into talking about, you know, the Shining Star Awards.
Because we're at the beginning of the year.
That's right.
Parents want to think about that.
Mm-hmm. So it's 9:20, Thursday, October 4th, 62 degrees, a little bit of clouds and sun outside, and again, broadcasting live from the studio here at Graphic Arts Department at Westfield Technical Academy. We'll be right back.
Fall on me with open arms. Fall on me from where you are. Fall on me with all your light. With all your light. With all
Support for Community Radio on WSKB is provided by Betts Plumbing and Heating Supply Company, an independent, family-owned wholesaler serving Westfield for over 50 years, specializing in plumbing, heating, and industrial piping supplies. On the web at BettsPlumbing.com or at 14 Coleman Avenue in Westfield.
Support for the community programming of WSKB is provided by the Dunkin' Donut Shops of Westfield and the Sardinia family. It's nice to know that even as the world changes, Dunkin' Coffee remains the same at 7 convenient locations throughout Westfield.
We thank the generosity of our underwriters. For more information, please contact the Westfield State Foundation at 413-572-8646.
It's Tuesday morning from 6 till 8. Wow, it's Tuesday with Bob Plass.
Community Radio,
89.5 WSKB.
Live from the campus of Westfield State University, this is 89.5 FM WSKB Westfield.
And we're back with Superintendent Spotlight with Zap and Chris. Today we're known as Say Your Piece with Chris and Denise, which I think will be a common thread for the next few weeks.
I think, well, throughout the year. I think, absolutely. I'll be dropping in and out.
Yeah, me too. 9:26 a.m., 62 degrees, mostly cloudy with some sun. Again, we're broadcasting live today from Westfield Technical Academy, the Graphic Arts Department, in our new TV radio studio that's coming along really well. We're really, really excited about it. And it's our pleasure today to have Rachel Bullock and Michelle Douglas from our CPAC. And, you know, as we were going to our first break, we were about to talk about the Shining Star Ceremony, and I really want to dedicate some time to that during segment two. But before we do that, Mrs. Rosala, we got some information we've got to share with our listeners.
Yeah, we do. It's early October, and we have a lot going on in the schools. We have open houses. Highland has an open house tonight from 6 o'clock to 7:30 p.m. On October 17th, we have early release staff development just for elementary students. There will be parent-teacher conferences. And then on October 25th, Southampton Road is having their open house from 6 to 8 o'clock p.m. And also, our Tiger's Pride restaurant is open. It opened yesterday.
That's
officially.
Right.
When we walked in, they had it all decorated in Halloween themes and
setting
up the
amazing
tables
today.
It's got its new look. It just looks great. So if you get a chance, come on down to Tiger's Pride. They didn't give us a menu yet, but
right,
our next show, I'm sure we'll be reading
right.
a menu.
Well, we're open. They're open today, and then next week, due to the short week, they're not. But then, you know, the following week, they're open on Wednesdays and Thursdays.
10:45 to 12:15.
And we've talked about it before. You know, whenever they have their buffet, I mean, their food is fantastic anyway. The students in our culinary arts department, you know,
amazing.
Under the leadership of Chef Rogers and Chef Muccheroni, they do such an incredible job. But we talk about their buffet all the time. For $8, you're not going to get a better meal anywhere.
Well, this morning,
and service.
We had pumpkin spiced coffee and coffee cake.
Yeah, absolutely.
That they had out for sale for faculty, and oh, it was amazing. So
they
yeah.
do such a great job.
I was very excited today.
So anything else you want to add to that, Mrs. Rosala?
No? No, I think we're good for now, because we want to get back to, you know, Rachel and Michelle.
Absolutely.
So that we can explain. We were talking about the book study that they were interested in possibly starting up, and then we want to get to the Shining Stars. So why don't we start with the book study, because that's what we left the last segment on, about bright kids who can't keep up, and you were saying you're trying to secure one of the authors to come in for your April meeting. But how do you kind of imagine having a book study with the parents?
Well, I would say that we have a Facebook page, so I actually have already posted it a couple of months ago, that saying that this I had read this book, it was an easy read, it was a great book to do, and that if people might be interested in reading the book, we got a few, I think we got like three or four people that said that they would be interested in it, so I would probably... To help facilitate and make it easier for people to be a part of it, probably go out and get the books myself, because that's how strongly
sure.
I feel about this book. And then you know, probably, so the meeting would be in March, so probably December I would start asking the parents who are really interested in this, and then get the books, get them out to them by December, January, have them read the book, and then keep reaching out to the authors to see who I can get, and then hopefully have those parents come to this meeting that have already read the book, and then we can discuss it with facilitation from the author.
I think
author.
Even if we didn't have the authors, that
you could still do some culminating event.
Yeah,
absolutely.
Because I know there's a lot that I could talk about with my son with that like describes my son to
sure.
a T, you know?
So if parents are interested, they can go through the website to email you, or
they can come to the website or join our Facebook page as well.
Come to a meeting and let you know.
Absolutely.
Or they can email us.
Awesome.
At westfieldcpac@gmail.com.
Right.
Awesome. Excellent.
I finally memorized it.
So the culminating event at the end of the CPAC calendar every year is the Shining Star Ceremony. And that is really a phenomenal event that recognizes some outstanding educators and people who are truly making a difference in the lives of some of our students. But ladies, you want to talk about what it is, the process, the nomination piece, and ultimately how it culminates.
Okay, go ahead. So we have nomination forms that our two parents have made for us between Melissa Rakowski and Laura Marks. They are our IT people. And so we have nomination forms that go out to parents. Usually we start in February. We get copies sent to all the schools, and then we also, now Laura was able to do it so parents can do their nominations online if they want.
Excellent.
And submit them through email to us, which last year it worked out pretty well.
The
majority of our nominations last year were through email.
Yeah.
And so we put those nominations up on our Facebook page, and then we also, Michelle, you email out the nominations forms to the people on our mailing list, and maybe this year we can try and get it up on the district school website.
So parents and guardians can nominate. Who can they nominate?
They cannot nominate anyone. Anybody who's touched their lives to help them improve their child, or whose child felt that teacher really meant a lot to them. Doesn't even have to be a teacher. One year, I think 2 years ago, we've had paraprofessionals. Last year,
awesome.
It was East Mountain Transition that really rocked it out of the park. And years before, we had a student nominate the police officer at the high school.
Right.
Nice.
So anyone who works in the Westfield Public Schools
with the children.
One year we had Mr. Fieri nominated.
Right.
And he won.
Awesome.
One year when it first started, I nominated a special education supervisor because she really helped us out. So it can be anyone.
Absolutely.
Anyone.
And it's anyone who has an impact on the lives of a student, that might be on an IEP and really is trying to create and foster a sense of belonging, relationships, and keep that perseverance, to keep moving forward and do your best, and just sometimes it's just to make your day brighter. We talk about it all the time. What makes a huge difference in the lives of kids is at least one trusted adult that they have a powerful appropriate relationship with, to help them in school. And it can be anybody, like you said. It can be a teacher, it can be a custodian, it can be
a
resource officer.
And that's
for any
child, not even a child.
That's correct.
And
relationships is one of the, district initiatives this year, building relationships with, our students, our staff, our administrators, our parents. So, because if you don't feel like you're a part of something, it can be a very difficult time, especially for our students.
Right, and lonely.
Absolutely.
And as a parent, it feels good when you know that there is someone on a day-to-day basis or a regular basis in the school buildings that are looking out for your child mm-hmm. and helping, you know, him or her to be more successful and or to be more positive. You know, when if your children come home and they're talking about a particular person, you know, that's making an impact, that shows you we're doing our job.
Well, parents entrust us to, you know, have their children, and we have their children for, you know, 6, 7 hours, 7, 8 hours a day, and it's a big responsibility.
Absolutely.
And like I said, those relationships are extremely important. So I think that's a wonderful. And when you go to the Shining Star event, it is just such a nice event. I mean, she made a beautiful photo book that just captured all of the celebration, and you know, you get a lot of people that attend.
We do. We do. We're actually very diligent. The Westfield Technical Academy makes our certificates, Shining Star certificates. They also make our invitations that we send out electronically now. So they help us out quite a bit. We also, Culinary makes star cookies for
mm-hmm.
us.
Nice.
Otherwise, this is a parent put on event. I mean, the Technical Academy is very gracious in helping us out. You know, each one of us parents that are on the board, we bring food and so and stuff, and we take the pictures. And so this is definitely a parent-driven event.
And the recognition that it gives some of our staff members, you know, if you get into education, you need to know more, and we would assume, you know, that you're in education because you love kids and you want to work with kids and you want to help kids. And this really spotlights to me and highlights, you know, some people that might be even under the radar at times and not be recognized for truly what they do. And then, I mean, to be nominated and win an award like this is, I mean, that's what it's really all about, you know, that intrinsic piece.
It's a fun night. You can tell that people are really, the kids are so proud to present the certificate to the person that they nominated. Bright smiles, everybody's happy. It's definitely a wonderful atmosphere to be in. We've had administration there to see it all, too. And stuff. And actually, last year, Mr. Velas, the representative, he was able to pop in towards the end, and he wanted to show his support as well. So it's a fun night. It's a real fun night.
I think we're really fortunate, though, to have such a strong CPAC in Westfield, because I just think that, you know, just looking at your calendar and events and all the things that you do. We're very fortunate to have you and the board or your group coordinate these kinds of wonderful events for our families.
Well, and we can also reciprocate to administration for being wonderful to us as well as putting on meetings. You doing the MCAS last year, a couple of years ago, the 504s and
And interventions and tiered processes. And, you know, that's...
Again, I mean, we couldn't do our group without you.
And you're right. It's that parent engagement, that family outreach piece that when it works really well. And I think we've got a pretty good, well-oiled machine.
That's what the CPAC is about. I mean, it's about, like, training parents. It's about being connected with the district and working with the district. That's a huge part of it too. So it doesn't really work if it's not reciprocal.
Correct.
So there's many different functions we take on, but
absolutely
wonderful.
Absolutely. In this month, being October, we talked a little bit about it off the air, but this month is Dyslexia Awareness Month.
Yes, it is.
So, and I know every month throughout the year, a different disability can be highlighted. But maybe you want to give us a little bit of an overview of what takes place or what Dyslexia Awareness Month is all about.
So, language learning disabilities are what my children both have, and they have been diagnosed with dyslexia. So, dyslexia is a language learning disability. Although I call it an exceptionality, that's what Miss Martha likes to call everything, and I like that term.
I do too.
So, it It's a reading disability, and it affects 1 in 5 children. Most kids who have a reading disability have some degree of dyslexia, and it's more of a neurobiological thing, so it's not that they have a deficit. It's just who they are
right.
and how they were made. So it's actually brain connections are being a little interrupted in some way, but through explicit language learning
programs,
thank you, like Orton-Gillingham or structured strategies. Literacy, things like that, you can actually retrain the brain to make those connections and learn to be able to read. Now, I don't know if you're aware of this, but they're actually, Massachusetts is trying to pass through a law about dyslexia and earlier and allowing to have an earlier diagnosis, because what happens is that they usually wait till the age of third grade,
which it's, you know, the K to 2 is, you know, learning to read, and then
right.
from 3 to 5 it's reading to learn. So you've missed crucial instructional time if you don't diagnose till, you know, a later date. So that makes perfect sense in the world of education and learning to read.
Right. And so there is a law, and we just got a notification that it's in the House of Representatives right now, and that it's moving on, and they said that looks favorable. And what this law would do is just allow for earlier diagnosis through K through 2.
Correct.
And so then they would be able to jump on it and not wait so long. So
I think that will be wonderful for children, because
absolutely.
There's often times where we suspect or, you know, but you can't fully come up with a diagnosis. So you're starting the interventions.
Right.
But that explicit instruction, if you had that real diagnosis earlier, would be so much beneficial. You could really put an individual, you know, education plan together in that. So, you know, good. That's exciting.
And actually, I think that my kids are in good company. There are a lot of famous dyslexic people.
Sure.
Throughout the world. So,
well, and again,
I think it's
October,
a wonderful thing they are.
Yeah, in October being Dyslexia Awareness Month, we just want to let the public know about that too. So thank you for that, Rachel. We're up against another break, folks. It's about 9:41, 64 degrees, mostly cloudy in Westfield, but a beautiful day. Again, Superintendent Spotlight broadcasting live from Westfield Technical Academy. We'll be right back.
Hold on to me as we go, as we roll down this unfamiliar road. And although this wave is stringing us along, just know you're not alone, 'cause I'm gonna make this place your home. Settle down, it'll all be clear. Don't pay no mind to the demons, they fill you with fear. The trouble, it might drag you down. You get lost, you can always. No, you're not alone.
'cause I'm gonna make this place yours.
Support for Community Radio on WSKB is provided by Betts Plumbing and Heating Supply Company, an independent, family-owned wholesaler serving Westfield for over 50 years, specializing in plumbing, heating, and industrial piping supplies. On the web at BettsPlumbing.com or at 14 Coleman Avenue in Westfield. Support for the community programming of WSKB is provided by the Barnes & Noble College Bookstore in the Ely Campus Center, offering Westfield State t-shirts, sweatshirts, and gift merchandise, all of your academic needs, and offering textbook materials in new, used, ebook, and rental formats. Available at the bookstore on campus or online at westfieldstate.bncollege.com.
We thank the generosity of our underwriters. For more information, please contact the Westfield State Foundation at 413-572-8646. We thank the...
It's Tuesday morning from 6 till 8. Wow, it's Tuesday with Bob Plass.
Community Radio.
89.5 WSKB.
Live from the campus of Westfield State University, this is 89.5 FM WSKB Westfield.
And we're back with Superintendent Spotlight, our weekly touching base in our weekly episode here in terms of sports. And wow, we've got some great stuff going on with our local teams. Westfield High School football, Pete, undefeated at 4-0.
I saw that.
Yeah, unbelievable. Taking on Chicopee Comprehensive High School tomorrow night at Chicopee Comp at 7 p.m. Our golf teams, Westfield High School at 8-2, Tech Academy at 3-6. Girls soccer for Westfield High, though, off and running at 8-1. And then at the Tech Academy, 1-5-2. They're battling. They're doing a great job. Boys soccer at the high school at 3-6. But boys soccer at Tech Academy, Pete, undefeated at 7-0. Field hockey, 2-7 at the high school. Girls volleyball off to a strong start to their season with 8-2. Girls gymnastics right there again, undefeated at 4-0, keeping that dynasty going. Boys cross country at both schools, they're running well, they're trying hard, they're doing their best, as well as the girls. And we've got a bunch of games and matches lined up over the next few days. Today we've got boys varsity golf and the PVIAC Invitational 2-Ball taking place at Oak Ridge Golf Club this morning, actually. And girls varsity soccer taking on Minichog High School this afternoon at Westfield High, 4 p.m. And boys, and tomorrow we've got boys, like we talked about, the football team taking on Chicopee Comp, boys varsity golf hosting Mohawk Trail, boys varsity soccer hosting always a great matchup against Ludlow, and then girls varsity volleyball hosting Lacona Regional on the 6th. Westfield Tech Academy today, boys varsity golf, they're also in the PVIAC Invitational. Girls soccer at Pathfinder today at 4. Tomorrow, boys varsity golf at Pathfinder. And boys varsity soccer, again, the undefeated boys varsity soccer team at Tech at Pathfinder at 4 o'clock. And Pete, the New York Yankees have survived the wild card game against the Oakland A's.
Survived? That's more like dominated. Yeah, 7-2.
Yeah, I wasn't going to say dominated. I was going to.
They dominated
the
Oakland A's yesterday.
They did, and it sets up.
I call a spade a spade. I'm sorry.
Well, it sets up the matchup that I think we've been talking about since April. Right.
Yeah,
that,
I told you.
Right.
What did I tell you?
Yeah, you were.
You guys were all depressed. You know, our team stinks right now. I'm like, it's going to happen.
Right.
Don't worry about it.
And then here we are with. Sox and Yanks open it up tomorrow night in the American League Division Series in Boston. Best of five. So it's the first time these two teams have met in the postseason since 2004.
Correct.
So, you know, and of course, back then, in 03 and 04, those were epic seven-game American League Championship Series, this right. one being a best of five ALDS. But still, there'll be electricity. The rivalry is definitely back. So I know anybody that's a baseball fan loves this rivalry, especially if you're a Sox fan or a Yankees fan. So we'll have plenty to talk about
next week. Yeah,
absolutely, next week, because the series will basically again taking place Friday night, Saturday night in Fenway, and then they transition over to New York for Monday, and if needed Tuesday, and then if necessary Game 5 the 11th at Boston as well. Indians and Astros opening up their American League Division Series tomorrow. National League both Division Series opening up today. Rockies and Brewers, Braves and Dodgers, and Thursday Night Football tonight.
Patriots.
Indianapolis, right, being hosted by the Pats.
I was very pleased. I just got a memo from Counselor Surprise. I have to go to a subcommittee meeting tonight. He said it's going to be quick, so.
And the other two local teams, the Broncos will be at the Jets 1 o'clock on Sunday, and the Giants will be at the Panthers, rounding out our NFL coverage. So bringing it back to CPAC, but before we...
Well, I have one
yes,
that
absolutely.
Kind of ties into the sports. And I'm not a big baseball fan, but I will be tuning in to the Red Sox Yankee for sure. But I have a really fun event that I want to share with everyone. It's the Westfield Centennial Lions Club is presenting Glow Golf. And this is where they use those fluorescent golf balls and they golf at night. Well, it's at Toccoa Country Club, Westfield, Mass. 5:30 registration, 6:30 tee off. There can be singles and teams are both welcome. It is a walking event, so carts are not provided. Costumes are encouraged.
Yes.
It's happening on October 13th, and proceeds will go to the Westfield Public School food drive. So that's a really wonderful cause. So if you want to just have, sounds like a great fun time. You don't have to be a great golfer. You just have to be able to be willing to come out and have a good time. So
right.
For more information, contact Carly Grimaldi, and you can email her at kg9587@gmail.com. Or you can message them on Facebook at the Westfield Centennial Lions Club. So it sounds like a really funny
It is. It's the second annual Glow Golf. The Lions Club came up with this last year. So last year's event was very successful, and it was a lot of fun. It's taking place on October 13th this year. And like you said, Denise, every year we have an annual Thanksgiving food drive.
And we have a real need in our community for
Absolutely.
Our food banks to
so
be filled.
All the proceeds from this event are going to go to that. It's a great time. Like Denise said, costumes are encouraged. $80 per player, raffles, prizes, food at Toccoa on the 13th. Please come out and support a good cause and have a great time.
So now, back to CPAC. And we have Michelle and Rachel. So, we were talking a little bit about flyers that you had prepared for the schools, and each school has a different flyer for highlighting their school and their, I guess, involvement with the CPAC. Would you, share with us, how that came to be and what's in these flyers and where can people get them?
So, for September, CPAC tries to be at all the open houses, at the open houses, what we do is check in with the principals. We have a flyer that's school specific. So the flyer just pretty much says, who the principals are, who the 504 coordinators are, and in that school, who are the specialty people that
right,
the parents.
Service providers.
Service
right.
providers, right, that the parents might need to get a hold of. We have the ETLs listed, their email addresses, what days they're in that building, who their special ed supervisors are, their emails, as well as, the nurse, the speech and language people, the behaviorists, just a little bit more easier access. Sometimes when you go to the school's websites, it's kind of hard to manipulate it and know where to go exactly.
And some of the special ed, staff does report both to a couple different buildings. So that's really nice for a parent who may want to be able to reach somebody and knows where to reach them.
And then on the back of the brochure, we have obviously, Westfield CPAC and the dates of our meetings, where we are, our Facebook page.
page and stuff. And then we also have, you know, the special ed department district level mentioned on the back as well. And I just wanted to say, especially this year, we reached out to the principals specifically to ask them to update our brochures. And I just wanted to say thank you to all of them for responding to us and giving us the updates. And then we fixed the brochures to make them current, because they change from year to year.
Oh, and we did have a lot of transitional changes in
Absolutely.
Our district. We have a new
brand new schools.
Yeah, new 5-6 school, Westfield Intermediate, a new 7-8, Westfield Middle. So you guys had to do a lot of work over the summer to prepare for that.
Right.
Right, and I can tell you, you know, as a parent of a student on, you know, on an IEP, I found those brochures always to be very helpful, because it again, it's who your direct contact people are, who your service providers are, and how to get in touch with CPAC, you know, and how to be part of CPAC, and I think that's a great piece. And Rachel, you talked about having the district level special education department highlighted as well, and I know you're currently working with Dr. Von Mehring on I believe there's a grant to help create an emotional support group.
Right. So I guess Dr. Von Mehring and Shannon Berry were able to secure a grant, and out of that grant, part of it is going to be able to help support an emotional support group for parents and slash caregivers of children who are on IEPs in the city of Westfield. So she said that she, as well as us, because right. she talked about it with us, felt that, you know, parents, really parents of all, need support on raising kids, but sometimes parents who are on IEPs, their children have disabilities. Some can be more significant than others. And, you know, parents are going through a range of motions. You know,
it's a roller coaster.
Navigating coaster. Just you know, the system. You're navigating the disability. You're dealing with so many things.
Mean,
home
homework
and school.
Getting them ready for school.
In general.
Look, he's gone, yep.
Well, and that's why I think this is such a tremendous idea, because with this type of group, you know, these are caregivers, parents, guardians supporting each other, helping each other, coming up with ideas and thoughts and strategies that somebody might not be thinking of
Absolutely.
Or may not have access to. So.
And we will, through this grant, we're able to be provided facilitators. So while it is a group of parents supporting parents, we will still have that person who has the knowledge.
Be a BCBA and most likely a
person
counsel,
from the Carson
right,
Center.
A social worker,
right, that will help just to be support and kind of give us guidance on, you know, strategies
but
and
there
things
will
like
be,
that.
There won't be any district people there, so people feel, it's not going to be really a group about, you know, IEPs. It's
right.
not like we're going to be talking strategies about IEPs. It's more about the emotion behind what you have to go through.
Going through a particular time. Because you said, you know, there's ups and there's downs, there's ebbs and there's tide. You know, and so, you know, in one person's particular life, they may need that support because they're going through something different, you know, whether, you know, it's family related that's impacting the child. These are all things that, you know, you could come together in a comfortable environment to be able to ask for support and advice.
Or just having a friend, you know,
right.
telling you, no, this year's going to be a marathon.
Or that
I had one friend say to me, she said, Michelle, this year's going to be a marathon.
That what you're going through is okay, and you'll get through it, but
right,
you know, you're
exactly.
going to need some time.
Right.
So
right. So we do have the BCBA, Jen Bogen, who will be one co-facilitator, and she said the meetings will probably be at the Forum House on Broad Street. So we're still meeting with her actually tomorrow to talk about a second co-facilitator, and that the meetings will probably start sometime in December.
Okay, that's sounds fantastic. And ladies, we want to thank you for you know, not only being our guests this morning on the show, but for all the hard work that you do behind the scenes with CPAC. We really have a strong, high-functioning, highly dedicated special education parent advisory council in our district.
Absolutely. And we really do.
We really do.
I want to extend my thank you as well.
We really need to get more people involved, though, because what happens with CPACs is they go through, you know, now we're here, and then our kids graduate, and then if we need that
we need fresh meat.
We need more people. So if there's anybody listening, and if you're interested in becoming involved, and it doesn't have to be at the level that we're involved, any involvement will help.
Right. There could be behind the scene things that they could do.
You can just email.
We need a decorating committee for the Shining Stars.
Well, there you go.
Yes, there's plenty of things. So you can just contact us at westfieldcpac@gmail.com.
Excellent. Perfect. Again, thank you, ladies. Thank you for your time today. Thanks for all the hard work that
you
do.
Thank you for having us.
You're welcome. Folks, we're at 10 o'clock. This is Superintendent Spotlight with Zap and Chris. But today, say your piece with Chris and Denise. 64 degrees. Beautiful day here in Westfield. Have a nice week. We'll see you soon.